Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Einstein's Back Porch. It's Sundays with Einstein. We're a little early today. Hope you can join us. Einstein's climbing around. Hey, Laura. Good to see everybody. I'm gonna move the camera. Hang on just a minute. There, that's better. It is warm here today in Texas. It's like, probably 85, 90 degrees Fahrenheit. It's sunny. Hi, good to see everybody. Okay, hope you all survived Halloween. We had a good time, and Einstein didn't get scared. Actually, it was raining that evening, it wasn't raining. It was just kind of cold, and we didn't have very many trick-or-treaters come to the house. Einstein, where are you going? Get down from there. I know it's snowing in some parts of the country or world. Einstein, you gonna get down and do some talking? Einstein, there's people from Finland. Oh goodness, 6 inches of snow. Ugh. Get down from there. We're doing fine. Okay. As soon as he gets down, I'll go into the other room and he'll do some talking. Or maybe even before. Cat lovers in Fort Worth, are you kidding me? Einstein has really been working on Birdie Brigade. He's saying it, and I haven't gotten it on video yet, but I'm sorry, I was trying to read a comment and it went away too quickly. We haven't gotten it on video, but he's saying Birdie Brigade. He says the brigade part real softly. Birdie Brigade. So anyway, okay, he's down from his little climbing escapade, so I'm gonna go inside and he'll probably talk. He hasn't talked very much this morning. Einstein, come back here. I don't really know where to put the camera where you can see. He's kinda hiding. I'll just leave it right here and he'll come down. Bye-bye, Einstein. We'll see you later, okay? Want to go fly? Whee! Let's go in. I'm going to go inside, Einstein. We'll see you later. Do some talking, okay? I love you. What's a birdie?
What's a rackle?
Come
here. raspberry?
Down there. You get back up there. You get back up where you belong. He's trying to get to the camera. Yeah. Or to the phone, rather. I'm using my iPhone. Where's Einstein? There you are. You gonna talk from there?
Look at the birdie.
Oh, I see the birdie. I see the birdie. Okay, I'll see you in a minute. There's more talk.
Peek-a-boo! God bless you. What's a turkey? No.
this up. Okay, see you later. Don't climb up there.
Welcome to Sam.
I see you just fine. Don't
welcome
to Sam.
You
want to talk to me? Go.
Peek-a-boo. God bless you. Welcome to Sam. Come here. Hey, sweet.
Where are you going? Get down from there. Sorry about that loud airplane, guys. That's kind of unusual. I don't know why it was flying so low. But it was really loud. Einstein, get down. Yep, Thanksgiving is just a gobble gobble away. It'll be here in just a couple of weeks. Gobble gobble gobble. We love Thanksgiving. And yes, Einstein does eat turkey just a little bit. And no, that is not cannibalism. He also likes to eat chicken, and that also isn't cannibalism. Peek-a-boo! Okay, thank you for getting down. Okay, Einstein, I'm gonna go inside again, okay?
Welcome to Sam.
Yes, I see you just fine. Okay, I'll answer a few quick questions I got. Does Einstein eat the bone marrow of the chicken? Yes, but I only give him organic chicken, cooked, and it has to be cooked very, very well. And Thanksgiving is a holiday we celebrate in America as the discovery of America. Oh, I'm getting a very bad connection message, but I'll just continue this. Christopher Columbus is credited as discovering America, and so when he came to America, he had a big dinner with the Indians and the Pilgrims and everybody and everything off on the East Coast where he supposedly discovered America. Actually, there were earlier discoverers of Columbus, but he's credited as being the earliest. Anyway, it's a big time when we all get together. We have this foolishly large meal, and it comprised of roast turkey, stuffing, sweet potatoes, corn, mashed potatoes, and every other dish that you possibly can think of.
Popcorn.
And popcorn. So that's what Thanksgiving is. It's just, and usually football. We all sit around and watch football after dinner, and it's just a time families get together and eat a lot, basically. Jeff and I sometimes go to a movie. Okay. Einstein, get back here and do some more talking, okay? God bless you. I'm going to try to move the camera over there, but he's probably going to... Oh, you're going to climb up there now? He sure is active today. Usually he just sits out here and talks, but he wants to do some climbing. And I'm going to have to get these other chains buffered like this. See how we have this to where he can't climb up that one? Jeff is supposed to make these other, but he hasn't gotten around to it. Einstein's 20 years old. Come back over here now. Come see me. Come see me. Peek-a-boo. Can you wave? Can you wave? Oh yeah, cranberry sauce. That's another thing we have with the turkey is cranberry sauce, but Einstein calls it cranberry. And yes, I do have a few videos for Thanksgiving, mostly pictures, but his cranberry video and his cranberry blog video. And I'm way behind on making videos, guys. I'm so sorry. I'll try to get one out this week, but I've got a lot going on right now. And I know that's no excuse, but life is getting pretty busy right now. There you go, Einstein. Einstein, cranberry. Cranberry. Want some cranberry? Cranberry sauce. Mmm. It's good. That's right. You're so sweet. You can come back over here and see me? Okay, you gonna do some talking? These comments are going by too fast. I'll go back inside here and I'll read through them. I'm on my iPad in the house. Okay, I'll be right back, Einstein. I'll see you later. Yeah, I know. I want to come see you, too. I want to come see you, too. Get down from there. Get down from there. You are silly. Does Einstein eat cranberries? Yes, he really likes them. He eats them raw. Peekaboo. I think he likes the seeds in them, honestly. I don't know that he really eats the cranberry part, but I think he goes after the seeds. Okay, can you wave? Can you wave? Can you wave? What about a pomegranate? He likes pomegranates too. And the only place he'll get them is here on the porch because they are messy. Cherries is a good idea. We don't get any real good cherries here. So we get those sweet cherries. We don't get those tart cherries. Thank you, Barbara, so much for the $2 super chat. Appreciate it. That'll be sent to a parrot rescue. The Wings of Love have purchased their land. They did get land for the new aviary. Now they just need to get it ready for a building. They need to put electricity on the property, water, plumbing, sewerage rather. A lot more work needs to be done out there. But Einstein, what are you doing? But yeah, thanks so much. Really appreciate that. In case y'all don't know, I support parrot rescues. There's far too many parrots on the market right now or in captivity that we don't need to be breeding anymore. So if you think about getting a parrot, think about getting a rescue. They're wonderful birds and they need new homes. Everybody deserves a forever home. What are you doing, Einstein? Does Einstein watch TV? Oh, yeah. He watches it with us. I don't know how much he watches, but he listens to it. And he'll react to our reactions. If we start laughing, he'll sometimes laugh. I'm going to move this over here. It's okay, all right. Okay, I just want to tell you guys, I've had this orb thing, that's what they call this white globe, for 4 years now out here. And this is the first time he's ever gotten on it. Yes. He's never gotten on it by himself. I've always either had to put him on it, but he is... He's chewing on something over there. I'm not sure what it is, but this is the very first time he's ever gotten on it. So that's how long it sometimes takes these animals or these birds to learn to like something. I think he's playing on a toy over there. He's chewing up a toy, rather. How long does Einstein stay out during the day? If we're home, he's out of this cage. He stays out of his cage most of the time, and his favorite place is either in the shower or on his drawer in the kitchen. And when the weather permits, we put him out here. What are you doing? I can't believe he's climbing all over this thing. I bought this when he was 16, when we built the back porch. You're just having a good time, aren't you? African Grey Parrots can live to be 60, 70 years old. I've known some that passed away at 30, some younger. But they pretty much have the life expectancy of a human. Does Einstein have a bird best friend? No, we have many that live, well, BB came to visit. I would consider BB one of his best friends. But locally, no, we don't really have Einstein get around other parrots very much. But we have many on the internet. We love Gotcha. We love Mr. Max. Oh, I just answered that question. Yeah, Gotcha, Mr. Max, Peekaboo Parrots. Those are our top three. And I hope all those fans watch Einstein too. I know we have some that cross over. What are you doing? Yes, whenever we leave the house, he goes in his cage. And sometimes we'll put him in his cage if we can't watch him properly, like if I'm cooking and Jeff can't supervise him. So yeah, sometimes when we're home, we'll put him in his cage if need be. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate it. I'm getting a lot of people that say we watch you every day, and I really appreciate it. We try to make videos on a regular basis. I'll try to get more out this week. To be honest, I'm involved with another project right now, so my time is pretty limited, but I will do my best to get something out. Einstein. Okay, I'm going to set this down and go back inside and see what he does. If he'll climb down. Okay, I just saw another question. Have I ever considered going on the Got Talent show? We have been asked, but the thing is, Einstein doesn't talk in front of an audience. He's not, okay, just a second. He's not trained that way. In a studio, and we've had him in a news studio, and he absolutely clammed up. He wouldn't say a word. So they're just like a child. They get very shy when they're in a new surrounding or around new people. And on a TV show, I just know that he would clam up. And also getting him there would be very stressful. Getting him on an airplane, particularly now with all of the security regulations and everything, it would just be too stressful. Yeah, some of you that have African Greys know what I'm talking about. The one at the Knoxville Zoo, the other Einstein, he's actually trained to do live bird shows, and that's his normal, everyday experience, so it's fine with him. He's perfectly comfortable with it, but for Einstein, it just isn't comfortable. Okay, sweetie, do some more talking, okay?
Wanna cook it? Wanna cook it?
You wanna do some cooking?
Okay, I have a question. Someone asked, would Einstein fly away if he was outside by himself? Yes. Einstein has wings. He's a bird. If he were to get scared, he would fly away. Would he come back? Probably not. Probably what would happen is that he would get so scared being in that kind of an environment that he would probably fly off to another tree. The chances of recovery are not very good for a parrot that flies off like that. Some do get recovered, but it's just not worth taking the risk. So whenever we have Einstein outside, he's always in a carrier. He's in his little travel cage, or he's on, you know, the back porch. So that's why we built this back porch, was for him, so that he would have a place to go outside and get some fresh air and sunshine. Also, I know he's been saying, wanna cookin'. He started saying that just recently because whenever I start making dinner, I say, Einstein, got to go do some cooking. Want to do some cooking? So he has started that new word. Lost Horizon just said, wouldn't trust a harness. Einstein was in a harness when he was younger, but he hated it. So I discontinued putting him in the harness. Also, it's funny that he's not saying anything about the squirrels or the birdies today. I don't know why. But another example is, you know, they just talk about whatever they want to talk about. And that beeping sound, I believe, is a crow. We've had lots of crows in the neighborhood this fall, and I think that's just his bad imitation of a crow. Okay, I guess we'll sign off here, folks. Looks like Einstein is going to settle down and do some preening. Yeah, make those pretty feathers. Would Einstein wear a Santa Claus hat for Christmas? No. I'll Photoshop one, but no, he's not going to wear a Santa's hat. Check out Einstein's t-shirts that benefit Parrot Rescue. I've got a couple of them there with him wearing a Santa hat. One is a Merry Corn. Well, both of them are Merry Corn shirts. Thank you all for watching. We really appreciate it. Love you guys. And I will see y'all next week. I need to fix this camera so I can sign off here, but... Einstein, can you say bye-bye? Can you wave? Can you wave? Yeah, wave. Bye, you guys. See y'all next week. Love you.